The Army and the Navy working together last night, building a sandbag barrier alongside the rising River Thames. The plan is to divert the flow of the river away from homes and towards low-lying land near Windsor Castle.
The natural floodplain is the other side of the river, goes over the Queensland, but I've never seen it look like a lake, which it does at the moment across there, so it's the worst we've ever seen.
On some Thameside roads, canoe is now the best way of getting about. Surrey police say up to 2,500 homes could be affected in the next few days. Many commuters may be facing rail delays this morning. Flooding in the Thames Valley is causing new problems on the Oxford to Didcot route.
We hope to run a limited service there, but that will be quite difficult for passengers. We do recognise that. We'll do all we can. The main route through to Reading, Bristol and South Wales is in reasonably good shape. And then the route down to Exeter, we've reopened some of it, but through the Somerset levels, it's still blocked.
From Worcester to the Somerset levels, many parts of southern England are now experiencing some of the worst floods in decades, and there's worse to come. More heavy rain and strong winds are forecast for much of southern England and Wales from tomorrow night onwards. Andy Moore, BBC News.